All right, guys, so we are here in La Jolla for the crest reveal and the color reveal for San Diego Wave. We're in La Jolla, somewhere where the houses are worth more than we'll ever see collectively together or ever earn in our lifetimes. We're really excited, Chiva. What do you think of what you see?
Man, it looks beautiful out here, man. I hardly ever come up here. And I
mean, we're gonna see
the new crest, the kit colors. I'm excited to see what San Diego Wave is all about.
We had to dress up for this.
Yeah, like it's, I mean, we're dressed fancy. Up a little bit. People really dress really nice too. We see really important people from the San Diego media world.
Yeah, so, absolutely.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully we get to meet Alex tomorrow.
That's the goal.
That's the goal. Hopefully. If she's here. If not.
Si no, está bien. Está bien.
We'll get her later.
Growing under the surface. And when the wave rises, it forms a crest. A shield symbolizing strength for our city to stand behind. A horizon to honor where we have been and where we are going. And colors, the colors of a sky as vibrant and proud as our culture. The colors of the sand we play in and the common ground we share. Colors that showcase the beauty of our Pacific Ocean and harness the power of the wave. San Diego, our crest has risen. Our time to stand together is now. The wave is calm.
First reaction to the logo, I like it. You like it?
It's better than I
like
thought.
It. I really did like it. You like it, Jerry?
Grab the thought of a city vibes.
I feel extremely privileged to now be part of a culture here in San Diego. That soccer isn't just a game, it's part of life.
Obviously a big day for the foundation of this team in itself. Just tell me, as far as building this team, obviously the first signing was a center back, as you said. How important is that defensive position for this team, and what kind of play style do you anticipate San Diego Wave having?
Just because I signed a center back doesn't mean we're going to be a low block team, you know, that's going to defend. I'm a massive believer that we want to play attacking football, exciting football, but you have to have really good defensive foundations. So that's why Abby was a key signing, because she can use the ball really well. She's really composed, she's really comfortable on the ball, but she can defend 1v1. You know, if we want to go in high press and we want to go and win the ball back higher up, we need players at the back that can defend really well with large spaces 1v1. So she was a key signing for us, as was Kaylin, because I think someone that can keep the ball out of the back of the net. But Kaylin's feet are so good, so we can almost have an extra player in possession so we can dominate the ball more. So, you know, we want to play an attacking style, but our defensive foundations are so key to that.
And speaking about Kaylin, obviously you mentioned the World Cup is coming up. Is that a talking point when negotiating, talking with some of these players as far as 2023 coming in and developing them and getting them ready for that type of exposure?
Yeah, absolutely. Listen, I played 130 times for England. Like, it's the pinnacle of your career is representing your country, and I think she's one of the best in the world from what I've seen. You know, I think if we can give her the platform, we've got a fantastic goalkeeper coach in as well, so I think if we can keep pushing her levels, you know, I think there's a real opportunity now with Canada for her to go and take that number one chip.
Casey, how important is depth going to be for the team with injuries playing a part and then now COVID also playing a part during the season?
Depth's really important. You want to make sure that you've got a good balance of experience and youth, but you've also got depth in every position, so that, you know, because the league doesn't break for FIFA windows either, so you need to make sure that you've got enough players on your roster, you develop every single player in that team so that when they're called upon, you can use them.
Behind, you know, Jill and Casey's really hard work, and everyone else behind the scenes, but, you know, obviously having a world-class striker like Alex, a proven winner, goal scorer on every different level, Olympics, World Cup, NWSL, you know, champion of all those. So, and she knows how to score goals in different ways, and that's really exciting. And I think, you know, hopefully I can bring a little bit of stability defensively and bring some experience in that facility as well. I think just, you know, obviously knowing kind of what the league is about, fast paced transition, you know, very physical. So I think just knowing that and preparing for, you know, all the elements that the NWSL is going to bring is going to be very exciting. And, you know, we're going to be successful right from the get-go. And I can already tell from the pieces that they're bringing in that, you know, versatility, you know, being fit, being fast, being physical, are all something that we need to do and need to bring, and those are the players that they're recruiting and that they're bringing in, so it's going to be really exciting.
So what type of soccer brand would you say that you bring with your play, with your style of play? I know being defender is one of the toughest positions out there. Literally, physically, you got to be an enforcer sometimes. What type of gameplay will we expect from yourself?
I think just the ability to read the game, I think, is something that I pride myself on. Not having to get in a physical battle. And if I do, I can bring that, aspect to my game. But I think just reading ahead and kind of putting fires out before they start, so to say. I think also just the ability to distribute out of the back and start. I really pride myself on being able to kind of put the ball where I want it to go, and I think, you know, kind of really starting the attack through our defense. And I think, like Casey said, with Kaylin Sheridan coming in, her amazing feet for a goalie, I think she has one of the best feet in the world. Obviously makes amazing saves as well, but I think just having the ability defensively to be able to play out of pressure and whatnot. I also think too is transition. Being able to be fit and fast and physical is something that's important, and there's so many quality dangerous forwards in this league, and something that we need to be aware of. So with all that being said, I mean, obviously easier said than done, and we're going to have bumps and hiccups along the way, but I think just looking forward to everything that the season has to come and the future as well. So,
one last question. Favorite pair of boots of all time?
Oh, gosh. That is literally a really hard question, but I remember in the beginning at UCLA, we were Adidas still. Wearing the Copas, the kangaroo, yes, with the, yeah, and you just double tie it and then just like get going. So, that's definitely probably my favorite boot. Yeah, thank you. Yeah. Or the Predator with the tongue.
So, welcome to San Diego. I know you're familiar with the area, Southern California and everything. So, what are you expecting to get out of coming into San Diego, starting a franchise as far as play? And what are you looking most forward to as far as the experience and playing in front of these type of fans, a little bit more Latino? I know you're familiar with the area. Yes. What excites you in that sense?
Yeah. Well, we've already seen the incredible reception from the city of San Diego. So just getting started with the next season, we're really excited about. I just want to obviously settle in and kind of see a lot of family that I haven't seen in a long time, really meet a lot of people behind the scenes that have been working on building this club for months on end. And then obviously getting to know my teammates. I've been teammates with Abidal Kemper with the national team for many years, but I've never played with her on the club side, you know, day in and day out. So I'm excited about a lot of those. When it comes to this city and the differences that it presents, my husband is from Tijuana, so he has a lot of family in Tijuana still. In San Diego, I have a lot of family as well in Southern California, so we're just really eager to dive into the community, get to know the area that we've decided to settle down at in San Diego, and just like look forward to kind of calling this home. I speak a little bit of Spanish. Please don't test me, because my husband, although he would probably be proud of me, I feel like I would let him down a little bit.
What excites you to playing here in San Diego?
Yeah. And I couldn't answer in English. it just excites me to be able to bring so many different people together, cultures together here in San Diego, and to represent women's soccer at the highest level, to give San Diego a chance to watch professional players at the highest level competing right here week in and week out, and inspiring the next generation of girls to want to represent their city and their country at the highest level as well.
What message to like a high school aged player would you recommend? Would you say go practice every day? What's the one thing that a high school aged Alex Morgan did to reach this level?
I think sports really gave me a lot of structure in high school, and I think it was just really good for me and my growth in high school. And I think it depends on where your ambitions lie, and if your ambitions in soccer are to make friends and to stay fit and be healthy, then I think that's what you go after. If your ambitions are to play professional soccer or get a scholarship in college, then of course you need to work every day. You need to do more than your teammates and your opponents do. You need to do that extra lap, that extra shot, that, you know, always thinking one more. So I think it depends on where, you know, where your ambitions lie and where your dreams lie. But soccer is such a great avenue to so many different things. Even if you don't see yourself playing soccer professionally, I think just the team aspect really helps in so many, in growing a person, like how a person, can go through a job interview or work as a team in a job. I think it's really special to have been a part of so many teams. I always am a big proponent of playing team sports, especially soccer in high school.
Hardest question for last. I asked Abby what her favorite boot of all time was. So if you can bring back a boot or a current boot, what's your favorite boot to play? You can just have those forever.
I loved the T90s. The ones with like it said T90 like in the middle right there. Yep, those would be my forever boot. Yeah. Thank you.
All right, guys, we're on our way back.
redo that. Not redo that, but like.
What was your first reaction to the crest?
Honestly, it looks like a really colorful crest. I like the color scheme just because I'm a fan of Grand Theft Auto Vice City, and it kind of reminds me of that electric pink in a sense. It's a nice crest. I thought it was going to be, you know, maybe just blue and white and a different blue, but I like seeing a little bit more color in there. So
I like the pink of it.
Yeah, no, it looks
a nice touch.
It's a nice touch. Hopefully, we'll see what the kids look like. But nice crest, nice everything. We got to talk with Alex Morgan,
with Abby,
Casey Stoney. Didn't get a chance to meet with Jill.
She's busy.
Everybody's busy.
But overall, I feel like the experience was great. We met everyone. We met everyone we needed to meet, and it was great. Honestly, it was a lot of fun. And again, thank you, San Diego Way, for inviting us to this event. Got to see a lot of cool friends that we've met along the journey. So it's been a lot of fun.
Get your pins at San Diego Waves website. Cool little pins. We're gonna go ahead and keep these forever. But again, thank you for having us, San Diego Wave, and we're looking forward to seeing the season start over at USD and then transition over to Snapdragon Stadium, to the new Aztec Stadium. JD Wicker here. SDSU needs to give me credit for doing this. Like, straight up, like,
yeah.
What other student of San Diego State is in the
reaching
minglings
on it? But man, thank you guys for watching this. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. And